Hello, world. All right. Sorry we're getting started a little late here, but welcome to a Google Plus Hangout. My name's Tim Quirk. I'm Google Play's head of global content programming, and I'm very happy and honored to be sitting next to Rashida Jones and Will McCormack.
Hello.
They probably look familiar to you. You've seen Rashida Jones in Parks and Recreation, and Office, and all kinds of movies, and you've seen Will on The Sopranos and on In Plain Sight. But the reason they're here today, maybe we can talk about some of those things, but they've also got a new movie that they co-wrote together. So I'm not going to blabber about it. I'm going to let you guys tell us what the movie is and what it's about.
We co-wrote a movie called Celeste and Jesse Forever that's kind of about a breakup, but it's more about a couple that's been together and wants to be friends but doesn't want to be married anymore, and they try to find a way to stay in each other's lives.
While pursuing other relationships.
Yes.
And can that work?
And is that possible?
So it's not will she end up with him, it's
will she not end up with him.
Yeah, and remain friends.
Can they be friends?
All right.
But we had both been in, you know, sort of dysfunctional relationships with exes that were difficult to interpret, and I feel like a lot of people had. So it was, it felt like a good premise for a film.
Yeah, well, it can be very hard letting go.
Yeah.
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 So how much of that real-life stuff wound up in the movie?
All of it.
All of it.
All of it is thievery from our own lives and our friends. Yeah.
So if something's happening to you, does that mean it actually happened to Rashida, or are you taking stuff from Will's life?
Both.
Both.
Both. There's definitely stuff that happened to me, though, for sure.
Yeah, and me.
And you.
Yeah.
Okay. Can you share one or two of the things that are real?
Well, it depends on who's seen the movie. Has anybody seen the movie? No.
I know.
You've seen it. There's some really bad dates that I go on, and that all happened to me.
All right. The song the model sings to you?
Yep. Yep, that happened to me. That happened to me. And really just, I would say, in general, the larger back and the push and pull of breakup. I miss you. I don't miss you. You know, the late night text, the can I see you, but we're not together anymore. That stuff has absolutely happened to me and doing too well.
Yeah.
Okay, well, we've got a bunch of people who sent in questions and asked to join the Hangout. So we're going to go with them. We're going to let them, when I call your name, please just introduce yourself, tell us where you're from, and ask your questions. So we'll start with Chantal.
Chantal, I'm from Southern California. My question was on the writing. How did you guys go with the collaborative process? Did you write everything together, or did you do different scenes or pages together or separately?
Well, we had been talking about writing together for a very long time and never managed to actually do it, but we talked about it a lot.
Yeah, there was a lot of talking.
And so,
not a lot of writing.
And
you actually have to write it. That's
that's the
horrible
thing.
Part.
That is the thing.
Yeah.
So we just decided that we were going to sit down and write this thing and just sit down every day until it was done, however long that took. And there was no expectation because nobody knew we were writing anything. Also, nobody cares because it's L.A. and everybody has a script that they're writing.
You say you're writing a script, people are like, great.
Yeah,
welcome
me
to
too.
The club. Yeah.
And my dog.
Yeah.
We did that. And because we were both, it was our first time really trying to complete the process, we supported each other, sat next to each other every moment, held each other's hands. Not literally, but
sometimes.
Sometimes, but just kind of talked through every beat of the movie, talked through every scene, and acted it out because we're actors. Did voices, did characters, and tried to bring life to it as best we could.
Yeah, it was nice to have a partner. I think we both had a lot of fear about being professional screenwriters, so it was nice to have such a good friend like help you and support you through the process of like your first real screenplay, because it's kind of vulnerable to show people you're writing. It's it makes you feel a little bit of fear, so it was good to have someone to go through it with.
Rashida, do you have that? Because, I mean, you're an accomplished actress, you went to Harvard, you're a vocalist, you're a model. It kind of seems like there's nothing you can't do.
There's a lot of things I can't do. I can't ride a bike, but I have a lot of fear. And I went to Harvard with all my friends were on the Harvard Lampoon, and that was the way that you were anointed as a writer, especially for comedy, and I wasn't in that crew, and I had a lot of, I was intimidated by my friends who were actual writers. I didn't feel like I could, you know, I was worthy of that title. So yeah, I was, it took me years to even consider writing or consider, and even now I have a problem saying that I'm a writer, even though I actually am.
All right.
Yeah.
Janine, you have a question, I think, about the music in the movie.
I do. What was the process of picking out music for the film? I found out about Porcelain Wrath through it, and I read somewhere that Lily Allen is on there too.
Yes.
Which makes me excited, so just wanted to know what that was like.
Music's a really big part of the film, and of any film. It can kind of like make or break a movie, and I'll unabashedly say our music is incredible.
So good.
The composers are Sonny Levine, who is
my nephew.
Rashida's nephew. And they have some talented people in our family.
He definitely got the gene. I'm afraid it might have skipped a generation.
No, you got it. You can sing.
Because he's my dad's grandson. So
her dad being Quincy Jones.
Yeah.
He's a genius.
And her mom was in the Mod Squad. So
but
I don't know if anybody would know that.
Yeah. Sonny wrote the greatest breakup album ever. It's called Love Rhino. So when we were writing the film, we listened to his music endlessly, and so that was sort of the musical inspiration for the film. But they did such a great job because the music's got oomph, it's got pace, and then it also has a sort of like melancholy streak. So they really, I feel like, understood the pathos of it, and they're really talented. It's Sonny Levine and Zach Cowie.
And the songs that they picked that weren't original, you know, are kind of classic in a way. We didn't want to do like, we didn't want to have the soundtrack of the moment because then the moment passes, you know? So
yeah.
We have like these great tracks from Brenda Russell and ESG and Lee Moses and, you know, just like these kind of classic musicians, and it complements Sonny's score so well, you know?
Yeah.
I'm really, really happy with the music.
Me too.
And there's also one of the characters in the movie is a pop star. And some of the best satire in the movie, I think, revolves around that character. But what I appreciated about that was you're not just taking pot shots at random, you know, young tween pop stars. It's an actual human being character. So tell me a little bit about that.
Well, we wanted to try to take some conventions, movie conventions, and create some surprise factor with that. And I think that, to me, those are the things that interest me when I watch a movie. And especially because Celeste is a super judgmental, thin-slicing person who's made a career out of it, we wanted to put her in the face of something that she would totally judge and just be convinced she was right, and then actually be sort of surprised and wrong. So she meets this pop star, played by Emma Roberts, who's so great in the film. And, you know, she's just decided she's this little tart, and she's wrong.
Pop-Tart.
She's a Pop-Tart.
Yeah.
Yeah, but she ends up being wrong, and she's got more wisdom and more gravitas than Celeste expects her to have.
All right, Zach. Is Zach with us?
Yep.
All right.
Hi.
Tell us where you're from and ask your question.
I'm Zach, and I'm in Oklahoma City. My question is for Rashida. I was wondering if you have any plans to perform or release some of your own music.
You know, one day maybe, yes. I love music. It's an integral part of my life, obviously, growing up. And I also have a lot of reverence and fear about being a musician and, you know, doing it in a way that would make my dad proud and would make myself proud. And it's the kind of thing I would want to focus intently and intensely on that for a while before I did it as like my main profession. But in the meantime, you know, I'm happy to just kind of casually slip in here and there. And, you know, I sang in a movie last year called Monogamy, and I sing backup sometimes or sing on Friends soundtracks and stuff like that.
If people want to hear you sing, they can get the first Maroon 5 record?
I sing backup on the first Maroon 5 record and also on one song on the second album too.
Okay.
Yeah.
Right. Corey. Is Corey with us?
Hi, I'm Corey. I'm from Texas. I wanted to know, Rashida, I saw you on Who Do You Think You Are? And I was so touched by you learning about your family and tracing that back, and I went and looked and found that you support peace first, and I wanted to know how that journey took you and where you are now with fighting crime and violence.
Yeah, that was a very unique and a gift of an experience to do that show. I always had a feeling that maybe, you know, we had a tragic Holocaust background in my family, because I knew we were Eastern European Jewish, and that story doesn't turn out that well a lot of times. And it was really intense. You know, my mom and I went to the forest where pretty much our entire family was shot and killed, and it gave me a renewed sense of gratitude. Not that I'm not so grateful for my life, but I felt like, you know, it was kind of my duty to move forward and bring attention to senseless violence and bigotry. And yeah, Peace First is a wonderful anti-crime, anti-violence organization that's in a bunch of different countries now. And it's a really well-tuned, well-researched program to basically teach kids how to cooperate and communicate and talk instead of fight out their problems. But yeah, it definitely rededicated me to that issue. I mean, obviously, I think, you know, violence is a problem in this country, and I think communication is the key. Teaching communication at a really early age.
Thank you, Yusuf.
Yes, hi, I'm Yusuf from Boulder, Colorado, and I remember Rashida, in one of your interviews, you mentioned that you used to see Michael Jackson at your house a lot. So I was wondering what that was like, and if that has affected you growing up and even in choosing your profession.
Well, Michael Jackson was such a special person, and he was kind of like part of our family because he was a kid when he started, and my dad met him when he was a really little kid and kind of took him under his wing, and he was great, you know. I mean, he was just like a big kid, and I went to school with all of his nieces and nephews, and we would go and after school, and I mean, just being around somebody that talented must have had some impact on me. At least it didn't shut me down totally and make me not want to ever do anything again, because who can possibly, in the face of that talent, who can even think that they're talented? But yeah, I mean, I think you are born with something, right? And you have to go towards the thing that you're good at. And obviously he had no choice. I mean, his talent was just, you know, bubbling over. I wouldn't say it really impacted my career choice, but, you know, I feel lucky to have known him.
All right, well, since we're sitting here in Google's offices, or some of Google's offices, a question I have to ask both of you, and I'll start with you, Will. When's the last time you Googled yourself, and what did you find?
Oh, no, don't get dark.
it rarely turns out well, does it?
I have Googled myself. It's been a few hours. you know, with the movie coming out, I've definitely Googled myself. And I've actually had to Google us because sometimes they need photos for us, and I never have any.
Yeah,
so they'll
okay.
have to pull something.
Don't worry about it. It's okay. You can Google yourself.
Yeah. It's been like 3 hours, so relax, Rashida. I've Googled myself, and, you know, I've read some good things and some bad things.
Rashida?
You know what, honestly, it's been a little bit of time since I've Googled myself. I used to do it a lot, but A, yeah, you see things that you don't want to see, and B, you see things that you don't want to see, but now it's kind of great in a way, because now it's inundated, because we have the movie coming out, and because I'm on a TV show, and because we're doing so much press, it changes all the time. Mm-hmm. So unless you're really digging and you really want to find something bad, you're not gonna find it. I've been Googling the movie a lot, that's been really fun.
Yeah.
And the reaction's been
pretty positive.
It's been great.
But you know, the bottom line is, around every corner, if you're looking for something,
you're
gonna find
something
it.
Horrible.
Yeah. If you're looking.
Yeah.
All right. Well, unfortunately, we're running out of time, so I'd like to thank our Hangoutees for joining us and asking their incisive questions. Rashida and Will, thanks for joining us.
Nice to chat with you and hang out.
I wish we could hang more.
Yeah. I know.
Those of you who want to discover more, you can go into Google Play. We do have a Rashida Jones collection right now. I think it's a bunch of movies and stuff that you can rent and or buy. So thank you, everybody, and we'll see you at the next one of these things.
Thanks, guys.
Later, y'all. Thank you.
Bye.
Bye.
Bye.